Hello, I'm Rod Hatt, the Chief Technical Officer at Coal Combustion Incorporated, or CCI. This is our video about the proximate, or the moisture, ash, and volatile matter measurements in coal. I've had a variety of jobs in my career, and here's my resume in golf balls. Today, we're going to talk about the proximate analysis of coal, and what it is, and a little bit about how we measure it and use it. I'm going to be using ASTM, and we're going to start with the D3172, which is the standard practice for proximate analysis of coal. If we read the standard, we'll see that we're going to be measuring the moisture, ash, and volatile matter in the coal. The sulfur and heating value are included in the short prox, but will be discussed in a separate video. So the proximate is basically a weight loss at different heating conditions. The moisture, ash, and volatile matter are measured this way. A fourth property, the fixed carbon, is measured by subtracting from 100 the moisture, ash, and volatile matter. So as a result, we see that coal consists of ash, fixed carbon, volatile matter, some residual or inside moisture, and the outside or surface type moisture measured by the air dry loss. Now the history of this test goes way back. Here's a guy back in 1726 talking about spirit of coal. And of course the gas and coking companies were very interested in this. So we're going to start with coal. Here's what a mine might look like. And of course, we've got to get a sample of the coal. ASTM D2234 covers this. And so whether it's a mechanical sampler or a automatic sampler or a mechanical sampler, we somehow have to get some portion of the coal that's representative of the total lot. If we use mechanical samplers, we'll have crushers involved. And even a hand sample has to go through a crushing process. This crushing process, of course, can impact the surface moisture of the coal. So any sort of crushing that we do or handling of the coal or exposing it to the atmosphere can alter or change that surface moisture. Now, once the coal has been collected, or the coal sample has been collected, we've got to get an actual laboratory sample made. And when we go through that process, we'll find that we actually have to air dry the coal. And so it's commonly to use an air dry oven now, though, although at some point we used to just spread it out on the lab and dry it. So we weigh the coal, dry it, and we're basically looking at the surface moisture. Now with bituminous coals, that surface moisture is clearly on the surface. The coal is oily, and so we get a nice clear separation. If the coal is a low-rank coal, sub-bituminous or lignite, we might get a more sponge-like reaction with surface moisture. And this, of course, allows it makes it hard to interpret the separation between surface moisture and inside or residual moisture, or what might be the moisture in the bed. When we go into the laboratory and do the air drying, we'll find that the bituminous coals reach a constant weight, as shown in this chart, where the subbituminous coals tend to losing weight. Once we dry the surface moisture off, we have to go pulverize it and make a 60 mesh or 250 micron type sample. And this is the actual laboratory sample that we'll be weighing and measuring the moisture and the ash and the volatile. So 3173 is how we measure moisture. Here's the old timey ASTM type picture. Of course, we would be maybe using a more modern technique today, but essentially you're going to be weighing out about 1 gram a sample. And so the residual or inside moisture is measured with about 1 gram, maybe higher percentage of the TGA device is used, or a higher weight of the TGA is used. Now, the next thing is to look at the rock or the ash content of the coal. And I'm here to tell you that there's a lot of rock and ash associated with coal, particularly if out-of-seam dilution is included. And sometimes this ash or mineral matter can include pyrites, which include sulfur and iron, or quartz, which is a very hard abrasive type material. And of course, the pyrites have a rejection system. Here's some rocks that came in and the pyrite was able to reject. But these are all part of the ash. Now again, we're going to be weighing out the 1 gram of ash in the crucibles. We'll be putting it into an oven with airflow and a set temperature to try to make sure that we burn the coal. ASTM will describe to you how much airflow you need or how to make sure that you get enough airflow to burn the coal. And then the next step is to actually go and measure the volatile matter. And 3175 is this test. What we're going to do is understand that high volatile coals are smoky and sooty and don't make much coke. And low volatile coals can burn cleaner or with less soot or smoke. And low volatile coals also make for more yield on coke products. The ASTM, of course, has a old-timey picture of what the volatile test might look like. This is when we're doing our 1 gram samples. And we'll actually lower it in and heat it up without the presence of air by putting a lid on the crucible. So again, we have the air dry moisture. This is the first stuff, the outside moisture, inside moisture, volatile matter and fixed carbon, which are the combustion portions of the coal, and the inorganic or ash type materials. Now, when we go about, and actually in a modern laboratory, we might be using the macro thermogravimetric test. Here's an example of this machine, and it will do the moisture, ash, and volatile tests all in the same thing. Now, when we got to convert these back so that we can use them to like the as-received basis, here's an example where we take the coal, about 4,000 grams, put it in the air-dry oven, and we see that it's lost 588, or about 14.26%. This is the air dry loss for this coal. If we were to heat that up to over 100 and maybe 110 degrees, we'll see that some inside moisture comes off, and we measure that 11.3. But of course, we're going to go ahead and go through this pulverization, and we're only going to use a 1 gram sample. And what we will see is that if we need to calculate the total moisture, there's an actual another standard, 3180, that tells us that we can calculate if your residual moisture is 11, your surface moisture is 14, you're going to end up with about 24% total moisture. So hopefully with a little bit of understanding about the moisture and ash concepts of the proximate test, a little bit about the volatile, we can go back onto our commercial basis and next video, we'll cover the sulfur and BTU, which are very important commercial aspects. And the whole idea is that by better understanding the tests that we're using, we can better understand the quality of coals. Thanks so much. I hope you enjoy this video.